Here's another work problem. Barry can mow the lawn in 55 minutes. If his son helps him, it gets done in 30 minutes. How long would it take his son to mow the lawn if he worked alone? So let's kind of decide if the son works faster or slower than Barry. If together it took 30 minutes and they worked at the same rate, then they would both take 60 minutes. But Barry only took 55 minutes. So the son must be working a little bit slower, right? So it's going to take more than 60 minutes for the son, since Barry could do it in 55, and the son must be more than 60, so it's probably going to be more than 60. All right, let's just make a note of that. Son takes longer than 60 minutes. So that's just something to keep in mind, because he isn't working as fast as his dad. Okay, so let's do a little chart here. We have Barry and his son, how long it takes them alone to complete the job, their rate, their time, and the work they complete. And remember, their rate times their time equals their work completed. So how long does it take Barry working alone? Well, it takes him alone 55 minutes, so his rate is the reciprocal 1 over 55. Now, how long does it take his son alone? Well, that's what we're looking for. So that's our variable. So we'll put in x for how long it takes his son alone. So his rate is the reciprocal, or 1 over x. Next, how long are they going to work together to get the job done? Does it tell us that? Yes, it gets done in 30 minutes. So they're each going to work 30 minutes. All right, so now we can do their rate times time to figure out how much work each of them completes. So Barry is 1/55th times 30, or 30 over 55. Now you could reduce that, because 5 goes into both numbers, to 6/11. All right, and the son's rate times time is 1 over x times 30, which is 30 over x. All right, so now what can we do here? Well, Barry gets 6/11 of the job done, so we know how much is left for the son. There's two ways to work this one out. Some people may say, well, this has to be 5/11 if this is going to add up to 1. Does that make sense? If Barry got 6/11 done, there's only 5/11 of the job left for the son to do. So that's one way of writing the equation, 30 over x equals 5/11. Okay? Another way to do it is to write an equation. Let's say you didn't know that that was 5/11. You know that 6/11, the amount of work Barry gets done, plus the amount of work the son gets done, equals 1. Now, these are equivalent equations, because if you subtracted 6/11 from both sides on this right side of the page, you would actually get 30 over x equals 5/11. All right, so now you can solve this. You could do this by cross multiplication. Anytime you have a fraction equals a fraction, the product along one diagonal equals the same as the product along the other diagonal. So I could put 5 times x equals 30 times 11. I don't like multiplying that out. I like to leave it in that form so I can cancel. So if I divide both sides by 5, the 5 goes into the 30, and I get 6 times 11, or 66. So that's one way of doing it. You might multiply 30 times 11, get out a calculator, and divide by 5. You'll get 66 as well. All right, now what if you did it this way? You might multiply both sides by the least common denominator, which is 11x. So I'm going to multiply each term by 11x. 11x times 6/11 plus 11x times 30 over x, and 11x times 1. So for the first term here, the 11s cancel and I have 6x. For the next one, the x's cancel and I have 11 times 30. So to do that, you just do 11 times 3 and add the 0 to the end of that number. And nothing cancels on the right side of the equal sign, I have 11x. So then we could subtract 6x from both sides to get 5x. And then when you divide by 5, you're going to get 66. So two ways that you might go about solving this problem, depending on how you write the equation. And both of them are correct. It's just how you think about it. All right, so let's look back up here. What did x stand for? That was how long it would take the sun working alone. The original problem was, how long would it take his son to mow the lawn if he worked alone? And remember, we estimated that it would take longer than 60 minutes because it only took his dad 55 minutes, but together they took 30 minutes, so he must have been working slower. So 66 seems pretty reasonable, but we will check it. So to check it, we could just draw the chart again and put in what we knew. We knew Barry alone was 55, so his rate was 1 over 55, and the work was 30. And we'd actually already figured out that that was 6 elevenths. All right, now, x. We didn't know what x was. Now we've got 66. So the sun alone, 66, so his rate is 1 over 66. So his work is 66 times 30, or 30 over 66, and if we reduce that by dividing the top and bottom by 5, I'm sorry, dividing by 6, we get 5 elevenths. So we've got that Barry does 6 elevenths of the job, and his son does 5 elevenths of the job, and does that add up to one whole job done? Yes. So we could check that 6 elevenths plus 5 elevenths equals 11 elevenths, which is one job done. So now we just answer the question. It takes his son how long? 66 minutes to mow the lawn. If he works alone. Ta-da! All right, see if you can go back and try this one on your own. Have fun.